Devo il freezer di mossa io ho basso mio shai. Dopo la sia apostles and elders that rule well and salutations to the brothers outside they pushing the wood in truth and sincerity, you know. As the picture I seen right in front of it's a brotherhood, you know, and that really is something that you really have to hold to the brotherhood, you know, the brothers in the truth, you know. Because we really can't be brothers to nobody in the world. We gotta be brothers to the ones that in the truth and doing the will of the Most High. You know? Because that who true brothers are. You know? Them are doing the will of the Most High. And it's really our glory to, you know? It's really our glory to be and an honor to be around men that serve in the Most High. Because it are brothers that around the world that be preaching by themselves, that they're doing this work by themselves, but you know what, they're still doing it, and they're still talking to brothers through the unicorn, through the internet. They're still talking to brothers from all around the world, you know. So it's our brotherhood, you know. So we have to hold to that brotherhood, because through that brotherhood, you know, if you're going off, or if you need corrections, our brother will tell you. Understand? So that brotherhood is an important thing as well. Is Matthew chapter 12. I'll start from verse 46. He say, While he yet talked to the people, behold, his mother and his brethren stood without, desiring to speak with him. Then one said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brethren stand without, desiring to speak with thee. But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother and who is my brethren? Right? And he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples and said, behold, my mother and my brethren. For whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my mother and sister, same as my brother and sister and mother. So yeah, so Yahusha was telling disciples that them that do the will of his Father which is in heaven, the same, you know, the same is his brother, sister and mother. But it's them that do the will, and that's the important part there. You know? You have your fleshly brothers, your blood brothers, but them not, most of the times, most of the brothers that actually have brothers, they're not in the truth. Right? And according to the scriptures, your real brothers is them that in the truth, that doing the will. Any brothers who will be pushing the word with you, preaching, you know, doing this stuff with you, that really your brothers. I know it's always been a nice thing to see that you could go online and even ask a brother a question, that you live in one place and the next brother living overseas, and that brother could answer you or even contact you, you know. And that the brotherhood, you know, them is die true brothers, them not actually doing the will. Will of the Most High. Because who else they want form a brotherhood with? Them that not in the truth? Right? Them that, who, you understand? Who you gonna, sit down, you could sit down and converse with your earthly brother. What he gonna talk about? He gonna talk nothing scripture wise. Nothing to actually edify you, you know. So what are you gonna do? That way Yahusha say, for whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same as my brother and sister and mother. So it's really them is really your brothers, your sisters and your mother, right? Yeah, because it's the brothers who need truth, some times and know that they help you out when you're going through hard times. Like when you're going through a little period, as I say, hard times, you know. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 7, it says, unto godliness, brotherly kindness. So the brothers in the truth, they really treat you with kindness. Them that actually, it's they that, you know, when you're doing this work, right, and you wake up someone and this person, this brother actually taking this word and he doing the word of the Most High, they go feel like you know this person for a long period of time, you know. A spiritual brother, right? See 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 7, it says, unto godliness, brotherly kindness, unto brotherly kindness, charity. Yeah, it was some brothers will help you, and you say, me, you will help brothers when they're going through a hard time, you know, that is brotherhood. Hebrews chapter 13 verse 1. It say let brotherly love continue. Right? So that is serious thing, you know. The brotherly love. Don't make that stop. Can't be treating your brother like an enemy. Especially the spiritual brother, them not doing the will of the Most High. That always continue that brotherly communication with love right through. Right? Because I mostly the brothers is mostly what you have on this earth here, right? Earthly wise, that way you really have, you know, your brothers to comfort you. The scriptures is to comfort you. And the same way brothers go help you out in times that you need, times that you're falling short, right? Like the scriptures say, you know, let brotherly love continue. Don't ever make that cease. Don't ever make that stop. Right, whoever make that stop. So brotherhood is really something that's not, you know, need to stand for. Say there's Romans 12 chapter 10. Say, be kindly affectionated one to another with brotherly love, in honor, preferring one another. So yes, yeah, so we'll be kindly affectionate one to another, you know, with brotherly love, in honor, preferring one another, because in the truth, you wouldn't prefer somebody out of the truth over a brother that in the truth. Anytime you prefer somebody out of the truth over a brother that in the truth, then you off in your mind, you're going off of the scriptures, right? You're supposed to, you gotta prefer. Hey, you can't prefer somebody that any will over a brother in the truth. That's truth madness. Right? Because that person in the world not even doing the will. A person is your enemy, matter of fact. Right? Yes, so, you know, always make that brotherly love continue. I'll make it stop. Yeah, right. Psalms. Psalms 133:1. See, a song of the praise of David. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. So yeah, it's really a pleasant thing to always see brothers dwelling together, you know, because who you really supposed to be around is these men that actually pushing this word in truth and sincerity. These are people that you need to be around, and who doing that is actually your brothers, right? It's really an honor to be dwelling with them in unity, in togetherness, you know, no malice towards one another. You know, you're dwelling in that unity. Really, honor. Say, verse 2, it is like precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the bed, even Aaron's bed, that went down to the skirts of his garments. as the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, given life evermore. So that is to show you how pleasant it is. You know, for brethren to dwell together in unity, that is to show you how pleasant it is, how important it is. So yes, so you know, so hold firm to that brotherhood, you know. Because I mostly, that the men that actually, that is righteous men, that the men that doing the correct thing in this world, they can't prefer somebody out of the shoot over a brother. Right? So, with that, you know, I say, all praises to Mosai, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shai. You know, double on to the apostles and elders going straight on, you know, and salutations to the brothers outside, they're pushing the word, truth, and sincerity. So, then we say, Shalom.